Here we are going to start with what we have in the first module. What is teams? What kind of capabilities we have? Why we use it? Teams and user. Good. So we're going to start with module one, and this is Teams introduction. What is Teams? Why we use it? What different capabilities we have? We are going to discuss many things in this one day training. In first module, what is include? What different kind of topics are included? Let's see. We'll see what kind of collaboration concept we have in cloud. Teams is providing you communication and collaboration, both experience. So how these are coming together? What different ways to use Microsoft Teams? How you can navigate Microsoft Teams end user portal? How to create team and their additional components like channels? And what are the backend components, the core components that we use for Microsoft Teams? A core component for Microsoft Teams is Microsoft 365 group. What kind of architecture we have here, why we use it? We'll discuss about all these things in this module.
Sounds great. Let's crack on.
Yeah, sure. So what is collaboration? You know, so since very starting, when you think about or when you see the IT industry move, if you see industry 10 year back, the way of collaboration between teams, it was different. Maybe every team is working independently. Every department is working independently. Suppose there are three departments: designing, planning, and operations team. And if you are all are going to work on a project, it was very challenging where these all three departments are going to work together in a streamlined, you know, experience. So what was happening, like if any, you know, designing team is going to design something, they were submitting their all the designs to planning team. Planning team is going to work on that project details or costing or many things. If they say something is not right, they return this all the project detail back to the designing team. Again, they were going to, you know, modifying them and then sending back to, you know, planning. So this kind of experience we were seeing, there were no direct, you know, collaboration between these kind of teams, these kind of departments. Over time, different kind of communication products. These are like from Cisco, from Microsoft, from any kind of third party companies. They were, you know, introduced in market and companies, they started using it. But again, in these all kind of communication products, they're all focusing only on the communication, but not on enhancing the productivity and also for the collaboration things. These all applications like Link, Cisco, Asterisk, or maybe Avaya products, these all were very good in communication, like chat communication, audio calls, video calls. These all were working well, but for collaboration, they were lacking with all these features, like where they can interact with files, how they can, you know, work in a kind of centralized place where they can communicate to each other. They can be a part of the discussions, how they can use different applications to manage their, you know, tasks, to manage their project timelines. Many things these were missing in the previous product design. Microsoft started with Microsoft Teams to design or to add all these things together in a single place. Microsoft Teams provides you collaboration experience. So we get not only communication, but collaboration experience. These are two different things. If you are very much familiar with Microsoft Skype for Business client that we were using, the Skype for Business client or Link client, these clients were only capable of providing you the communication facility. So when team people, they are going to work together, then we are looking for more and more collaboration features. Because when they sit together, when they communicate together, if they have common platform to work on the data, to work on the files, output speed will be enhanced for any kind of target, for any project delivery. So that's why Teams is going to give you all these capabilities. So people, they can work together. So using Teams, Microsoft is changing the way of integration, the way of collaboration that we have seen in all these, you know, previous years. How this is going to enhance? With many demonstrations and with many, you know, lab activities, you will see how this is going to enhance your productivity. Generally, when we start talking about Microsoft Teams, we think this is just a kind of communication product. I can call, I can chat. Okay, that's completely fine. But these are the basic features of Microsoft Teams. We have much more collaboration experience. So let's see. So for collaboration, if you have seen, like, in very early days, it was the time of 2008. Yeah, if I remember correctly, this was year of 2008. There was a very good product launched by Google. It was Google Wave. If you've used it, you know this. Google Wave was a kind of product where Google introduced a single website platform where you can use all your Google products in a single window. Google Drive, Gmail. At that time, there was not Facebook, but it was Orkut. You were using Orkut there for social connectivity, GCircle. And whatever the photos were there, everything was in a single platform. You don't need to open all these capabilities in different separate browser pages. But this was failed. This was a failed product, failed launch, because people, they were not, you know, ready to use these kind of things. But after so many years, like 7 to 8 years, Microsoft, they came with a similar kind of design where Microsoft Teams, that is a kind of product from your Office 365 licensing. This is capable of connecting with SharePoint, Yammer, To-Do List, Power Applications, Power BI, Power Automate, OneNote, Dell, PowerPoint, Word, Excel, Outlook, Forms, Stream, OneDrive for Business. Everything is integrated in Microsoft Teams. You don't need to switch to these platforms mainly. When you are going to talk about all these platforms, you can directly use them inside Microsoft Teams very easily. So all these applications that you see, Outlook, Stream, OneDrive, Yammer, SharePoint, these all things are already integrated, and you can see collaboration experience for all these products in Microsoft Teams. Apart from what we get in communication, so we get, you know, huge benefit for all this collaboration. We can easily work on the you know, data, work on my SharePoint sites or Yammer or whatever, the OneNote, Word file, Excel file, whatever you want to use, you can directly use in Teams. Previously, when there was no Teams, we were using Skype for business client here. And in this case, these all were working separately. There was some kind of integration between that we have seen between SharePoint and OneDrive and Yammer and SharePoint, but not all products were working together. So when I can see all these product experience in a single place, definitely this will save my time. And also I can easily manage my data. So how this looks like, how we use it, I'll demonstrate. So you can see, the theme is now going to be as a kind of hub for your productivity. You get communication experience with these kind of applications. You can enhance your productivity using productivity applications. Your collaboration will be enhanced using OneDrive, SharePoint, Stream, Dell. You can innovate, or you can create, you can use Power BI for business forecasting. You can use Power Applications to generate, to create new applications. And why not to use Power Automate to automate your general processes, day-to-day activities. So here, Teams is going to work with all these applications together. Now, one thing I would like to clear here, we will discuss about what are the capabilities and settings options we have in Microsoft Teams client, but definitely this training is not related to give you understanding that how Power Automate works, how Power Apps works, how Power BI works. So in this case, if you're interested, definitely you can go for dedicated training. But here we see how to integrate these applications to Teams, but not how to work on these applications. So this is not in the scope. Because when we talk about Power Automate, this looks very interesting. How I can automate my day-to-day activities in my production environment, in my office, and I can save my time. This is very helpful. I've seen senior management people, they use this Power Automate a lot. So if they are doing something on daily basis, in any kind of repetitive task they have, they convert this repetitive task in Power Automate. And that would be working without your interactions. So yes, if you're interested, you can go for these kind of trainings. We have dedicated training for these specific products as well. So Team is going to be a kind of hub for productivity, a centralized place to use all these applications. So what other things you get? So first thing, how you use Teams. To use Teams, we have different ways. First thing, we have Teams desktop application that you can download for laptops, desktops, available for Windows, Mac, Linux, or all the operating system. We have Teams client available. You can download, and if you have valid ID and password provided by your company, by your admin, you can use it. Apart from this, we have browser-based Teams client. Your browser, all the browsers are supported. Safari in Mac is in preview. Sometimes it's supported and sometimes it's not supported. It means this is something that I'm seeing in experience for some weeks, around 2 to 3 weeks. In month of January, it was available. And then again, this was disabled by Microsoft they're still working on, you know, compatibility with Safari. So all others you can use without any challenge, but yes, for Safari, you will see unexpected behavior. In desktop application and in browser, generally you don't get any difference in user experience. Both desktop client or web client, both provides you similar experience, but only some additional things like in Microsoft Teams, we have a kind of service, we call it live event.
Hello?
Yes, please.
Hello, hi, I'm Craig. Sorry, what's your name?
My name is Saurabh.
Saurabh, okay, cool. Saurabh, I don't know if you've got any background. We use Teams on a daily basis. Pretty much everything we do is revolving around Teams. But at the moment we use it on probably a really basic level to make calls, to set up some files, to send chats. So we kind of understand the real basics. What we're trying to get into is some of the fundamentals where we can set up channels, teams, link it back to SharePoint, and really start to access some of the clever fundamental aspects of the collaborating tool that you've mentioned.
Okay, so
if that helps a little bit.
Yeah, so we have these topics as well in upcoming modules, like related to, you know, channels, SharePoint and other things. So if you are willing to go for that kind of topic directly, I can, but I think it would be recommended to go with these kind of modules one by one.
Yeah, sure. The reason for me adding that was I think it would be wise to maybe spend more time on the channels and kind of blip through this early part, because I think everyone on this call is quite familiar with this part. We've been using Teams for about 3 years now.
I think in this case, we can skip these kind of things, right?
Yeah, cool. Thank you.
Okay, good. Thanks for confirmation. Okay. So,
thanks a lot.
Yeah. So let me go for moving to the next topics. Like, these are the very basic thing. If you're using Teams since long time, so definitely you'll be familiar with what we have kind of desktop application we have for browser based. And yes, definitely you have option for mobile application. So how to use Teams, you know very well. Good. Navigating. This is your Microsoft Teams panel. This is the client, or you can say like client experience, where you can going to get lots of, you know, tabs here. So definitely you will be familiar with this one as well, but let's have a quick information here. This is your activity tab, where you can see all the activities related with replies, if somebody is going to mention you in the Teams, and likes and other informations. Chat, where you can initiate chat for one-to-one chat, group video calls. These all things you get in this tab. This Teams tab is very important, where you create teams and channels, you manage it, the settings related to these stuff. Everything we control from this place. To manage meetings, configure, schedule, you will see your calendar. These all things comes under this calendar tab. Performing calls, audio, video calls, and if your Teams client is capable of doing PSTN calls, you will get dial pad inside this calls tab.
Hello, and this it's Craig again. Sorry to interrupt. Just to let you know what our experience is on this front page from myself. Activity chat, yeah, kind of get that. Calls, get that. Teams, files, and calendar. No, I don't. We don't really fully utilize them, and that's certainly the areas that we'd be interested in looking at more extensively.
Yeah, I agree 100%.
So you are looking for these things, right?
Yeah, we probably use the really basic functions of Teams. We send each other pictures and messages, business related, of course, and chat and we set up meetings through it. So we activate, we go into the calendar and we click on to launch the meeting. But with regards to how it actually works and what goes on behind the scenes and links up to SharePoint and the actual team access collaborative working spaces, then that's where we've never really had any, we've never had any training. As COVID hit, we got thrust into the world of Teams and basically had to find our own way.
Mm-hmm. Okay. So definitely we have discussion around these, you know, so we will go for this one as well. Yeah, so this will be going to be interesting here when we're going to see how to create teams and other things. So I'm jumping to this one, just give me a minute. So this one specifically is representing OneDrive for business. Whatever OneDrive for business feature you have, that will be presented here in this files tab. Whatever files you have in OneDrive for business, you can see here.
Is other OneDrive the same as SharePoint?
No. OneDrive for business is a different thing, and SharePoint is a different thing. So yeah. I'll discuss about these kind of comparison as well. What is OneDrive for business? What is SharePoint? So good to inform me. Yeah. From here, you can add whatever different applications you want to use. We have around more than 1300 applications in catalog in Microsoft Teams. These applications you can add in Microsoft Teams to use it, like Power BI, Yammer, and Forms, and Planner. These are all from Microsoft and many other third-party applications. So we have 1300 plus applications in catalogs. How to use them, how to add them, I'll discuss about these kind of discussions as well. First, let me go for, creating a new team. How you create a new team? There are different ways. Generally, you create a team using Teams client. But even in that, we have different kind of teams type that you can create. So to create a new team, the first thing is your admin, organization admin, he can block your access. If your admin don't want, you will be creating any kind of team, he can block it from back and side. But if you're allowed, it means you have create team options available in your team's client. How this will be looking like, how you are going to use it, what different options we have to create teams, I'm going to demonstrate. But before going for any team creation, these are some checklists that you have to understand. First, if you're allowed to create team or not, okay. Does a team for this group of people already exist? If any group is already there, any team is already there. So definitely if you have any group, you can use the same group to create a team for them. Why? Because team is always dependent on a Microsoft 365 group. So if group is there, you can easily enable these kind of group for a team. Or you can create a team from scratch if you like to. What is your team name? If this is a kind of org-wide team, you know what is org-wide team? Anybody? If they can explain what is org-wide team?
Organization-wide team, is that the question?
Yeah, what is this? If you have created this one?
No,
I don't think we have.
Okay, this is very helpful and very, very easy. So I'll discuss about this one as well during the demonstration. If you want to create a team for public or private, public and private, public team is available to everyone. Private team is only available to the members, or people can request to join in private team for private discussions, for private informations. How to create, we will discuss about. Is there any already SharePoint site, Yammer group, a stream group? Because I can create groups in our sites in SharePoint, in Yammer as well, and stream and these can be enabled for teams. So it's up to you if you are going to create a team from Teams client, or you have these kind of sites like Yammer groups, sites, and you can enable them for team very easily without, you know, going to create a new team and putting some extra efforts there. But if you're creating team, you have to decide who will be the owner, who are going to be member of this team. If you are going to invite guests, you're creating a team in your company and you are going to invite a vendor as a guest to communicate in this team or channel and participating in conversation. So guest, you can add, how to add, I'll show you. And is this team based on a team that already exists? You have option to clone any existing team. If any team is already working, you want to clone that team for some other purpose, we have this cloning option as well. So you have to check for these all checklists, and definitely you can create teams very easily. So let me show you how this looks like, how to create team with different options. I will use one test account here. Yeah, this one. I'm just going to get one user ID that we will use for the demonstration. I have, okay, let me go for this Megan user. For example, I have Megan user in my company, and Megan user is going to use Teams client to perform these kind of activities. Megan and password. This is Megan user welcome page for office.com. Office.com is your Office 365 ID that is provided by your admin. So you log in here in this page with office.com. And in this application launcher, you can directly click on Teams tab here. Teams. When you click on this Teams, this is going to open a web-based client. You know very well. Here, I'm not going to use Teams desktop client here because this will disconnect this meeting. So you can perform all this activity, what you're going to see in your Teams desktop where you log in with the proper ID and password. I'm still waiting for this. Clearing now. Now this is your Microsoft Teams client interface. And here we have this Teams tab. The question is how we can create these teams, how many ways we have. Very simple option and very simple activity that you would be performing is going to this Teams tab, join or create a team, and here you get this option, create a team. When you click on create a team, you get different options from scratch, from a group or team, and you can create a team using some kind of sample templates that can managed by, you know, that can be managed by admins. So from scratch, I want to create one team. You can see three options. What is private, public, and org-wide? Difference between all these three, private is only designed for a specific user that you add manually. If any user is going to request this, you have to approve for this kind of membership. But public is available for everyone. Anyone can request to join, and automatically that would be added in the Teams. Last one is org-wide. For example, there's a need in company. Senior authority is saying, okay, I need a team where all company members should be automatically added. I don't want to ask them to search for the team and add them. In this case, you can create org-wide team. In org-wide team, all your company users who are enabled for Teams, they will be the member of this org-wide team automatically. You don't need to add them manually. So for example, you are going to create a team for a new year event and you want to add everyone in this team. So you can go for org-wide, but we have a limitation for this. Org-wide team or this option will not be available if you have more than 10,000 users in your organization. This is only for 10,000 people. If in your organization there are 10,001 Teams user, this option will be automatically removed from here. There's only up to 10,000 users. So for example, if I create this one here, org-wide, and selecting new year event, create. Notice this is not going to ask any user details. And if you go for the membership tab here, in manage team, in this properties, you can see some members, they are added as owner here, and many others, they are added here as guest. So how Teams is going to select this? Nestor, Megan, Isa, and this MOD admin, they all have some kind of admin rights. So if they have admin rights, they will become owner automatically. And all other people in your organization, they will be added under the member list. You don't need to add them manually. So if I want to communicate something, I can use this team. Notice one thing, team members will be automatically added or removed to reflect your Active Directory. So in this case, this is a kind of org-wide team, and this is going to be added here automatically for all these kind of members stuff. But if I go again and create a team here from scratch, we have again org-wide team option. Maximum, you can create 5 org-wide team in any organization. After 5, this option will be automatically removed. So this is org-wide, where you don't need to add anyone. In private, maybe typing project X team. Create. And add members here. So maybe I'm going to add members like Alex as member, Alan. For sure, I can add them here, and I can change their role in owner or members if I like to. But if I would like to add any guest, I can add from this place. You can see this kind of external email ID, not like this organization. So this is going to be added as guest. So adding guest is possible during the team creation or even after, once you want to modify the settings. So as guest, close this one. Now you have Project X team. This can be used for communicating to all my company user because this is org-wide team. This is a kind of private team. This can be used only for communication between owner and all these kind of, you know, members and guests. So this is the private one. You have public option as well. Again, create a team from scratch, public, where you can just simply type, for example, cells. You can add members to cells. This public team will be visible to all your users in company, and they can request, they can simply click on join tab. So Alex. And Fernandez adding all these here. And Klaus. Apart from this, if you have any requirement to clone any team, go to join or create a team. Again, create a team option, and you can go for the second option from a group or team. Here, we have two options. One is you can create a team from existing team, or you can create a team using Microsoft 365 group. This group, my admin will create in Microsoft 365 Admin Center, and I can use this if this is available. So let's first see how to clone a team. Click on team, which team you want to clone. I want to probably clone the sales team. You can see the name. Maybe these all people are going to work as a marketing team as well. And here I can select what I want to copy. I want to copy applications. I want to copy the settings. I want to copy the tabs. I want to copy the channels as well. You can select accordingly. And if you want to copy the members as well, you can select this checkbox. Create, and marketing will be created here. Cloning a team is pretty much possible. You can add more members if you like to. I'm happy with this. Skip this option. But sometimes you'll be seeing this option here in the second tab. This is highlighted. Why this is highlighted? Because my admin, they have already created some 365 group in admin center, and that's why I'm seeing this one here.